Good morning, student. We are learning chapter 4, nervous system. So student, in lecture 1, we have learned about brain. So first I'm going to revise what is brain, what are the type of brain. The first question is, what is nervous system? The system that control and coordinate the action of all other organ system and organs of our body is called nervous system. Means all the control and coordination is done by a special system inside our body that is known as nervous system. Then we have discussed about brain. Brain is the control center of human body. It is protected by skull. It is present inside the skull. Then we have discussed about part of brain. So brain is divided into main three parts: cerebrum, cerebellum, and medulla. Cerebrum, it is the uppermost and the largest part of the human brain, uppermost part. It is responsible for learning, memory, intelligence, speech, and logic. Cerebellum is just situated below the cerebrum, It helps us to run, to walk, to play, and it also maintains the balance of our body. Then the third part is medulla. Medulla is the base of the brain, means the lowermost part of the brain is medulla. Medulla keep working even when we are asleep. We are sleeping, it is continuously working. It controls the involuntary action of our body. Involuntary action, which are performed by involuntary muscles. We have learned in previous chapter of our heart, muscles of our means breathing and heartbeat are involuntary actions. These actions are called medulla. So student, these are the part of brain. So now, today's topic, nerve. What are nerves? A network of nerve is spread throughout the body. Nerve cell or neurons. Nerve have been transmit of messages from organ to the body and organ to the brain and from brain to the organ. These messages are spread by some messenger known as nerves. These nerves are made up of nerve cell, and nerve cell are also known as neurons. Another name of nerve cell is neurons. Nerves are made up of nerve cells known as neurons. Nerves from head and neck directly join the brain. The nerves from head and neck directly join the brain, while nerves from the rest of the body join the spinal cord. Spinal cord, which is present inside the spines. Nerves carries messages from the sense organ to the brain. And student, as you all know, what are the sense organ? We are having 5 sense organ: eyes, nose, tongue, skin, and ear. These are our sense organ. So these sense organ send messages to the brain, and brain will send control or command to the sense organ or any organ of our body, any other organ of our body. So the brain, nerves carry messages from the sense organ to the brain. Brain interprets them and then tell the body the way in which it has to react. So first, these messages are carried by the nerve cells. Nerve cells carry the message to the brain. Brain decode that messages, read that messages, and give command, tell the body in which way it has to react, how the body will react. how our organ will react. That message will be given by the brain. So this is the function of nerve cell. Nerve cell carry message from each organ to the brain. Brain read that message and tell the organs how to operate, how to move, how to react. Again, the nerve cell carry this command message to the relevant body part. So brain will give the command and nerve cell will carry that command to the relevant body part. For example, your eyes see that there is an insect on the floor. There is an insect on the floor. Nerves carry the message from the eye to the brain. So eye will see that insect and that message will be carried by the nerves and nerves will send that message to the brain. The brain understand and tell the legs muscles through the messenger nerves to avoid stepping on it. Then brain will give command to our legs. Brain will tell to our legs that do not put your legs on insect or to avoid stepping on it. That message is given by brain. Our legs cannot understand that whether we have to jump over the insect or we have to put our leg onto the insect. Our legs cannot understand. That message will be given by our brain. So student, in this way, these nerves perform their function. Inside our body. So in simple way, you can remember that nerves carry the message from each and every organs of the body and send that message to the brain. Brain understand that message and give command to the body part. And that message will also be carried by nerves. So nerves are acting like messenger. They just carry the message from body part to the brain and from brain to the body part. Type of nerves. So there are three kinds of nerves, each of which has its own special function. So like we are having three parts inside our brain, in same way we are having three type of nerves. First, sensory nerves. These carry messages from sense organ to the brain or the spinal cord. Sensory nerves related to the sense organs. These sensory nerves carry messages from the sense organ to the brain or the spinal cord. Second type of nerves are motor nerves. These nerves carry order from the brain or the spinal cord to the part of the body, such as to the muscles and glands, which respond accordingly. The first part is sensory nerves. Sensory nerves carries message from the organ to the brain, from the organ to the spinal cord. Now, the brain will think about that. The brain will read that message, or our spinal cord will read that message. Inside our body, student, always remember that the command is given by the two main part of our body. First is brain. Brain will give the command. The second is spinal cord. Spinal cord will also give the command. Many of our action is controlled by spinal cord. And many of the action are controlled by brain. So we cannot say that all the body part are controlled by brain. No. Many of the body part are controlled by spinal cord also. So second type of nerve cells are motor nerves. These nerves carry order from the brain or the spinal cord to the body part. Now brain understands that message, which is given by sensory nerves. Spinal cord understands that message, which is given by sensory nerves. Now spinal cord and brain will give order to the body part or muscles or glands, which respond accordingly. As the message given by brain or by spinal cord, our body part will do the work according to the message which is given by brain or spinal cord. Third type of nerves are mixed nerves. They carry message from sense organ to the brain and also carry order from brain to the spinal cord to the other part of the body. These are mixed type of nerves. Mixed nerves, both type of nerves are there. They carry message from the sense organ to the brain and also carry order from the brain or spinal cord to the body part. So these type of nerves are known as mixed nerves. These are known as mixed nerves. So student, always remember, there are three type of nerve: sensory nerves, motor nerves, and mixed nerves. Now, do you know, if you think up all the nerve cells in your body in a straight line, it will measure over 600 miles in length. Yes, it is also an important information for you. If you join all the nerve cell of your body, the length will be 600 miles. 1 mile is equal to 1.6 kilometers. So when you multiply 1.6 to the 600, that length will be in kilometer. So I think that length will be 960 kilometers. Okay, that much kilometer will be the length of the total nerves present inside our body. Okay, student, now time to answer. You will do that time to answer by yourself. Now the next page, spinal cord. We have learnt about spinal cord. Spinal cord is present inside the backbone. Spinal cord is protected by the backbone or spine. Backbone or spine. You can see in your diagram that brain is connected to the spinal cord. Okay. And do you know which type of joint is this? Yes, this is pivot joint. The spinal cord is a thick bundle of nerves. Many nerves are joined together and they will form a bundle. It extends from the medulla of the brain to the lower part of the backbone. Means medulla is the lower part of the brain and spinal cord is connected to the lower part, and that is connected to the lower part of the backbone. It is surrounded and protected by a tough and flexible vertebral column and connects to all part of the body. So it is protected and surrounded by vertebral column. And our spine is made up of vertebral columns. And vertebral column, or we can say spine, it will protect the spinal cord. The messages travel from the sense organ to the brain and from the brain to all part of the body through the spinal cord. All the messages from our brain to the sense organ travel through the spinal cord. So student, understand this line, that all the functioning of our body, the movement of our body, we are raising our hand, we are twisting and turning our body, we are moving, that is just because our brain will give message to the different part of the body and they will act according to that message, and all that message will travel through spinal cord. So spinal cord is very important part of our body. So messages travel from sense organ to the brain and from the brain to all part of the body through the spinal cord. Through the spinal cord. And who will protect the spinal cord? Spines. That is a question from your previous chapter. Spines. Or we can say backbone. We can say backbone. Now, what is reflex action? Reflex action. Some of our actions are involuntary. Involuntary means that is automatically. We cannot control them. They will happen automatically and instantaneously. Instantaneously means quickly, with no delay in time. They happen on their own in response to stimulus. These actions are called reflex action. Reflex action. For example, watering of mouth at the sight or smell of delicious food is a reflex action. You just think about ice cream, you just think about golgappas, you just think about your favorite food, and there is some water coming inside your mouth because of reflex action. Now I'm talking about ice cream. Many of the students are like ice cream. Now, what is going on inside your mouth? There is a water coming inside your mouth. That is just because of reflex action. Reflex action. The second example you can take, that when you touch a hot glass of water or hot pan inside the kitchen, your hand automatically move in backward direction. When you touch any hot object, your hand will quickly comes in backward direction. That is also a reflex action. When you are touching a hot object, brain is not giving the command that put your hand in a backward direction. That command is given by a spinal cord. That command is given by a spinal cord. Spinal cord will tell to the hand that quickly move in backward direction. This object is very hot. That is why we can quickly respond to that type of situation, and that is not given by brain. Our brain will not give the command. That command is given by a spinal cord. Spinal cord. And this type of action is known as reflex action. Reflex action. These automatic actions are controlled by spinal cord. Spinal cord. These actions do not involve brain, because the messages to carry out such actions are sent by spinal cord. These type of actions, these type of command, these type of order are given by spinal cord, not by brain. So reflex action is happen just because of spinal cord. No involvement of brain will be there. Brain will not give any message in case of reflex action. Reflex action is happen just because of spinal cord. Spinal cord will give order to our hand when we are touching any hot object. Spinal cord will give the command, put your hand in backward direction, put your hand away from the hot object, otherwise your hand will burn. That message is given by spinal cord to the hand. The next is stimulus. Stimulus is any change in an external or internal environment that can be detected by organism. Stimulus. The first word is response, second is stimulus. Any change in internal or external environment that can be detected by organism. We can take the example of that hot object. Like we are boiling water in a pan and we accidentally touch that pan. Our touching and feeling that hotness is the stimulus. And our hand is going backward direction, that is the response. So stimulus is to know about any change in internal or external environment by an organism, that is stimulus, that is stimulus. And the action performed by after stimulus is known as a response. When we feel it is hot, we respond to them. We respond to them. So when we accidentally touch a hot object, accidentally touching is a stimulus. The sensory nerves carry the message of pain to the spinal cord from the skin. Skin is a sense organ, and skin is a sense organ. So which type of nerves will be there? Sensory nerve. These sensory nerves carry that message that this object is hot to the spinal cord, and spinal cord will give order to our hand that put your hand away from that hot object. And this is done in a very short period of time, quickly, instantaneously, quickly, in a fraction of a second. And who will give that message? Spinal cord. Okay, the spinal cord send an order to the muscles of the arm through the motor nerves, and order the muscles of the arms through the motor nerves. Before we even know about it, our hand jerk away from the hot object on its own. जब तक हम उसके बारे में सोचते हैं, तब तक तो हम अपना हाथ वहां से हटा चुके होते हैं. And who will do this activity? ये activity कौन control करता है? Spinal cord. Brain यहाँ पे work नहीं करता, क्योंकि जब तक brain उसके बारे में सोचेगा, तब तक तो हाथ जल चुका होगा. तो तुरंत से हम अपने हाथ को हटाते हैं. ये मैसेज दिया जाता है स्पाइनल कॉर्ड से, आर्म के द्वारा. ओके, सो स्पाइनल कॉर्ड विल गिव दैट ऑर्डर. नो इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ ब्रेन विल बी देयर. द ब्रेन विल थिंक आफ्टर दैट रिस्पॉन्स. सो आवर हैंड जर्क अवे फ्रॉम द हॉट ऑब्जेक्ट ऑन इट्स ओन. दस रिफ्लेक्स एक्शन आर डायरेक्टली कंट्रोल्ड बाय स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. Reflex action are directly controlled by spinal cord. This mechanism save us from serious injuries because it happens instantaneously, quickly. At the same time, we are touching the hot object. Instantaneously, we are putting our hand, we are jerking our hand away from the hot object. And that is done by spinal cord. Spinal cord will give that command. No involvement of brain will be there. Some other example of reflex action are coughing, sneezing, blinking of eyes, yawning. So these are some example of reflex action. These are not done by our brain. These are done by spinal cord. These are controlled by spinal cord. So student, look at the diagram carefully. So motor nerves are there. Then direction of impulse, muscles or effectors, sensory nerves are there. The pain receptor cells in the skin. So when we are touching, we are getting some pain. So direction of impulse means message is going to the spinal cord. And spinal cord will think about that, and spinal cord will give the message by the motor nerves. And there will be a reflex action, and we put our hand away from the hot object, and that is done by spinal cord. So student, now I am going to revise the today's topic. What we have learned, about nerves. A network of nerves is spread throughout the body. Nerves are made up of nerve cell, are also known as neurons. Nerves from head and neck directly join the brain, while nerves from the rest of the body join the spinal cord. Okay, so nerves carry messages from the sensory organs to the brain. Then there are the three type of nerve cells: sensory nerves, motor nerves, and mixed nerves. Sensory nerves carry the message from the sense organ to the brain, or to the spinal cord. Motor nerves carry the command which is given by brain or spinal cord. These nerves carry order from the brain or the spinal cord to the part of the body, such as to the muscles and to the glands. Mixed nerves. These nerves also carry sensory nerves and motor nerves. They carry messages from the sense organ to the brain, and also carry order from the brain or from the spinal cord to other part of the body. So these are three type of nerves: sensory nerves, motor nerves, and mixed nerves. Next, we have learned about spinal cord. Spinal cord is also doing the same function as done by brain. So brain is also a command center. It is also giving command. Spinal cord is also giving command. It is also control the movement of our body. Many of the command are given by spinal cord. Like when we are touching any object, like we are, if there is a dust particle inside our eyes, blinking of our eyes, sneezing, coughing, these type of actions are known as reflex action, and they are controlled by spinal cord. So what is a spinal cord? It is a thick bundle of nerves. It extend from medulla of the brain to the lower part of the backbone. Means lower part of the brain to the lower part of backbone. All these means the spinal cord is protected by backbone, or also known as vertebral column, flexible vertebral column. Then we have discussed about reflex action. What is reflex action? Some of our actions are involuntary, means these actions are performed automatically without our command. They act automatically. So this type of action is known as reflex action. Then we have discussed about stimulus. What is stimulus? Any change in external or internal environment that can be detected by organism is stimulus. So student, these are the reflex action and spinal cord. Hope you get the explanation. If any doubt is there, you may ask your question one by one. Okay, Akash sir, allow the student so that they can ask their doubt. They can ask their question. If any doubt is there, student, you may ask your question one by one. Akash sir, allow the student so that they can clear their doubt. They can ask their question if they are having any doubt.